تماشاگرین هجا بخیر بینو بو برنامه کی تایبت ایم ل برنامه امجارت برنامه تایبت امجارده ایم باسی راستیدا روزی نیم نتایج کوبانی دکین وقت زانن دوای او خوراگری که ل کوبانی بو درستیدا او مسئله بشوی کی آوابو او خو یعنی خو پاراستنو او مقاومتی که ل کوبانی کرا ل آستی جهانی دا دنگی دایوا و لپازده سپتامبری سالی 2014 درستی دا هزی هر تاریک و هر ناانسانی لدنیا دا وات داعش هریشی کرده سر او شاری کردی کوبانی لسوریا و هریشی که بربلاوی کرد به چکی گوره او چک قرسانه که لعراق و لسوری لارتشی سوریه و دستی هنابو و به پشتیوانی چالاکانه دولتی ترکیه قطر و عربستانی سعودی داعش دراسی دا هریشه کی جهانی بوسر انسانیت و دوای اوی که توانی بشه کی زور لخاک عراق و سوریه دا گیر بکا و کو آگادارن و از هدف و آرمانجی سرکی او رخصنا او بو که دراسی دا سیستمی کی تایفگری دا بمزرنه و که تواوی نرخ سرطایکانی دموکراسی آزادی و یکسانی بخات جرپه سرای او زور له دولتکان پشتیوانیان کړل داعش و وکو وسیله یک بو اویکه برژوندی او قازانج خو یې پیش بخن لکاتک داکه دولتي ترکیه پشګرتی د کله داعش بو اواکو او دسکوتانی ګلی کورد کبدستی هنا بو ور بګریته ول ناوچدا او سټاتوس یې ک کورد لناوچدا بدستی نه ور بګریته و قطر او دولتي عربستان سعودیش پشتیوانیان کړل او بهوی تایفه گری به هوی هوی تایفه گری لو مسئله پشتیوانیان کردو و تنانت هندک ل هزکانی اروپایی هزکانی رجعوایش ل لای چی دیکوا او هز رجعوایانه دراستی دا چاوی کی یعنی چاوی خویان نوقانت چاوی خویان قوچانت ل او کارانه که داعش دیکل ل روانگی عبوری و هر وها برجواندیکانی که بو اوی هگمونی خوی داسپنه لگل او پشتیوانی دا داعش بردوام بو لسر هرش وحشیار نکانی خوی و تناند لمنطقه دا و لهمو جهان او آگادار بو که دستی کر با او هرشانه که او زانن لفرانسا لزور جگایدی که ولاتی دنیا روی دا و او چشه دراسی دا حتا کو استابو تا هوی کجرانو لنوچونی بسدان هزار انسان و او چشه هروا بردوامه که میلیون ها انسانی لجگای خوی حلقندوا و بوته سببی نخوشی و سببی برسیتی و هر وها لشاوی پنابران لجهان برو شونی جر بجر جهان. دیارا جهانیش دیتی که او خوراگری که لکوبانی کرا او مسئله دیت که براستیش لهندگ لگوش جهان هشتا دکره لأو بهایانه و بایخانه نونتویی دفاع بکره و بتایبتی او بریاره که جنان لکوبانی نشانیانده او بو به هیوایک به دیجی او تاریکایی که آیسیس دیوی دایسپنه و لولامی او دا وکو آگادارن لیکی مجداری سالی 2014 روژی جهانی کوبانی را گندرا و خلق لسر تاثر جهان لدور یکتری کوبونه و بو دفاع کردن لآزادی و محکوم کردنی او هزانه که پشتیوانی لداعش دکن بتایبتی جنانی کوبانی و هر وها جنانی شروانی کوبانی و بیرو رای گشتی پشتیوانیان لیکردن و او توانی ویتی که او امپایره دا بروخنه که استا داعش به هیوابو بیروخنه و دزانن که لو دوایانش دا بو هرشه که للاین ائتلافی نامنتوی و هر وها پیجمگی کرد و هر وها شروانانی کرد بتایبتی لباشوری کردستان کرا و برو او آزادی موسل لوانه د توانین بلین که لسال وگری ویژن روژ جهانی کوبانی دا دراستی دا روژکانی داعشیش دا جمردره لو پروگرامی ام شموانده لو پروگرام تایبتی دا اما چندین میوان من هی لولاتانی جور بجوری اروپایی را که بخویان به شویگ لشوکان هر کامی کن دا پیوندی لگل هاو پیوندی دا گل خباتو دا گل بجنگلی کوبانی دا کاریان کردو و هندگ لوان بخواهن به شخص چوبون کوبانی جا اما حول دادین لو پروگرام تایبتی دا بوچونکانی اوان هر یک بزانیم بزانیم دو ماوی دا لماوی او سه سال رابردو دا لسال 2014 و دوای اوی که دوای چوار من که خوراگری لکوبانی که کوبانی جاری که دیکه کوتا و دستی گلی کرد در حال او ماوی دا چیان کردو و پلانی دا هاتویان چونه و لیکی نوامبر و یکی یعنی یکی مجداری او سال دا چدکن یکم میوانی من برز خانمی سیلویا تودسکینیا که با ماوی اک بخوی لکوبانی جیاوه. You are very welcome to our special program.
Thank you very much.
First of all, can you say some words about your activities? I know that you are a social activist and you have been living in Kobani for a while. Just if you introduce yourself in some words, please.
I was mostly in the canton of in Jazira canton. I was also traveling around in Kobane and I went also to Shingal, to the mountains above Shingal, I have the privilege to witness what the Rojava revolution actually is, and what I've seen is something that is completely different from what I could imagine before. And like, for example, I make some example of things that I've seen over there that I think are like an example of how things works and how are different from what I personally, for example, could imagine before. Yeah. Like here, for example, if there is a crime, if there is something that we do one against the other, I steal you something or anything like this, we go to court, we refer to the state, and then the state is the judge that decides according to a law that is a written law. Who is guilty and what we have to do. But then I went to Rojava and I saw the communes, and in the communes are the neighborhoods that decide what to do. Yeah. They speak with me, they speak with you, they try to find a solution all together to decide what to do
if
there is a
crime. So you mean that people can manage their lives beyond the state?
Yeah. There is a way to organize ourselves, themselves, without the necessity of a state.
It's
to build up
you?
A society, a democratic society. You understand what I mean? Like something that is belonging to the people, where the people are the subject, where the people together in a collective way.
Okay, can deciding. I ask you about, first of all, I mean, what was your motives? Because, you know, Italy we have a very long history of anti-fascist and democratic movement in Italy, especially after the Second World War up till now. And at the same time, if you just explain to me a little, if you can, because in order that the viewers to know about the activities there, and then the solidarity in Italy, and the things that you are doing in Rojava as a group.
Okay, actually that was the first time that I went to Rojava, and it was the first time that I went to Kurdistan as well.
Yeah, it was in 2014. 14, yes.
And I stayed there almost 2 years.
Yes.
Because like I was going there just to try to understand what was going on, because like the news that were coming was I was curious, to see. And what happened was that I went initially to Bakur, to Pirsus.
Yeah.
And in Pirsus, Sruç is this city in front of Kobane.
Yes.
And was the time
at the other side of the so-called this divided border.
Borders of the state. Yeah. And I was looking at Kobane and I was looking at that resistance and I was thinking, well, that's great. They are fighting for something. They are fighting because they believe in something, okay? And so I wanted to see with my own eyes what they were fighting for.
Yeah.
And that's why I entered inside Cizre Canton.
Yeah.
But at the beginning, I didn't imagine that I could have taken so much,
So how is, if you can describe for me, from the reflection of your activities in Rojava, in Italy, I mean, how the people are they open for solidarity with the people there? For instance, what are your expectations for the forthcoming 1st November, the Kobani Day?
For example, for the Kobani Day, I think the 1st of November is the day that reminds us how important it is to resist together.
Yeah.
Because in Kobane there was this resistance against fascism that is, as you said, like a kind of similar to our resistance against fascism that we had in Italy, for example, but that was in many other places as well. And like was a collective resistance, was a world city that was saying together, yes, we want to fight against the fascists.
But I think the general public in Italy, they have some, let's say, prior information about the Kurds, because as you know, in 1998, Mr. Öcalan was for a while in Italy, and then because of this international, let's say, conspiracy, so he could not stay there, although later when he was tried in Turkey and he was sent to Turkey, later they said that he has a right to live in Italy. I think the general public, they know something about the Kurds, I think.
Yeah, they know something about the Kurds. There are initiatives that are in program in some cities. I think there will be some artists, some events concentrated most on the art, and people are looking at Rojava, are looking about what's going on there, and they're also listening about the ideas of what's going on there. It's not just the solidarity that is essential and is very important about what people are doing there, like to bring help, but it's also solidarity that is like looking of what is experimenting there, what is like what people are doing, so that we can
most
maybe
of,
learn.
Yeah, most of the people, when they have, for instance, I have a book here. This is a book in Persian. It has been edited by artists and different people who have written it. I mean, from Iranians, Turks, Kurds, everyone. Most of them, they speak about when it comes to the Rojava, they the thing that they force them or they interest them to think about it is because it's a new model. Everybody knows that the other models have not been working. But this is something that inside, I mean, while you have a very big fight where everything is just upside down, there is some a kind of a glimpse of hope. That's why people are supporting it. Do you have the same impression?
Yes, of course. I think that what I coming back from Rojava to Italy, the thing that I'm bringing more with me is exactly the hope that you're speaking about, the Bavaria, the fact that you can see what's happening in Rojava, and that was something that before we were just able to dream and to think as something that was far away and that was almost impossible to reach in a lifetime or whatever. And then you go to Rojava and you see, okay, there are a lot of difficulties, okay, nothing is perfect, but you see that the direction where the things are going is exactly the direction of the ideas that are behind this. I make you an example. If we say that, for example, the state is the extreme form of patriarchy and we want to fight against patriarchy, then there is the unity of women, the whole organization of Congress Star that is organizing all the women and putting the women together. And this is the best way to fight patriarchy and so the state and whatever. If we say that we are against the gerontocracy, I mean the power of the old people, then what we do is to organize the youth. And the youth organizing themselves, they're able to build a new way of thinking, a new way to see the reality. If we say that men and women should be equal and that men and women should have the same right to do politics, to do whatever they want to do, if we speak about freedom of women, then we can see the co-presidency, the system that where there is a man and a woman that are leading together, that are guiding together.
These are the indications of the new model that it's interesting.
Yeah, and that's what makes me believe that it's possible, because it's not just a word that you read in a book, it's something that you see with your own eyes.
So lastly, what are you going to do next for Kobani and for the people of Rojava?
Well, for sure, what I would like to do is to tell to everybody what happens over there, because I think that everybody should know and everybody should try to believe that it's possible, because I believe that what's going on in Rojava is not just in Rojava, it's the future that we should all look for.
Okay, thank you very much. بینرانی خوشویست، بینرانی خوشویست، تماشاکر انهجا، میوان دوهم اما برز الیسیو آرکونزویا، الیسیو آرکونزو بخوی شورمند کمیسیون دروی پارتیا چپ ایتالیا و هر وحا اندام کمیته پشگرتی کوبانی ایتالیا و وابزانم ده چند خوندن زانینگهی ویژیه یا You are very welcome, برز آرکونزو. Can you please introduce yourself? Because I said that you are let's say working with the left party in Italy, but it's better that you are introducing yourself.
I'm political advisor, legal advisor for a parliamentary group of Italian Freedom, Italian Left, and Left Ecology Freedom, which is political party active in Italy. But I'm also activist, social activist from social movement.
Yes. Okay. In your, I mean, as a, your capacity as a social activist, what you have done for the Kobani people?
So not just myself, but yeah. even with the others,
and as a group, as a collective,
collective, and the network that we have built up during the, especially from after the siege of Kobane, that was called the Rojava Calling, was a network of activists, of social center, and even of the organization that support the revolution of Rojava, and from then. First of all, we tried to talk about Rojava and what was happening and the battle and the struggle of the Kurds against Daesh. Then after that, we started to even support in a humanitarian way the people of Rojava. So then we built up a project, first of all, the sanitarian project, and then we sent to Rojava even medicine, but also the people that work with the people of Rojava. And then we started with some other projects. And one of them most important for the, was the Academia delle Donne that we started even with the other comrades in Kobane.
Yeah. Is it, I mean, this Academia, what the Academia is dealing, working with, especially?
Yeah,
is this a special field or what?
Yeah, special field, but it's very important that it's not just for Kobane. I mean, it's important to Kobane that we'll have a new building for the Academy of Women.
Yes.
But it's also important to our country to speak about what the position of women in the Kurd society and what will should be even in the, our country, like in Italy, that it is something that we are also understand. About the woman.
So the struggle of women of Rojava, especially in Kobani during the Kobani resistance, how it has been reflected in the media in Italy?
Yeah, it's very important. I mean, it has been one of the focal point, even because we organized a delegation, very high level delegation. For instance, the YPG commander, Nesri Abdallah, was in Italy. Mm-hmm. She was in several programs at TV. She made an interview, and for that point, the position of the woman was discussed in our country in a different way.
Yeah.
Not just about the rhetoric of the woman that combats against Daesh and the fascists, but also the from the point of the protagonism of the woman in the society, not just in the military way.
Mm-hmm.
That was sometimes focalized most important in.
So among if we of course this is the general expectation from the left movement to be supportive of such a model that we have in Rojava. But if we take about the so-called established political parties, mm-hmm. what is their position vis-a-vis Rojava and the movement there?
Well, it's not easy to say because at this moment Italy has something that is changing than in the past. Mm-hmm. So in the past there were a big political party like the Communist Party and also the party that have more strict relations with the other party in the Middle East.
Yeah.
Now it's different because there are other kind of party, more center-right party, and the traditional left has been more distracted, I'll say, to the struggle of Middle East. But in a different way, there's been some social movement that are being more related to the people. So, I mean, also local council or social center that are a place that do a politics for the battle, not at high level. So they start to support the struggle of Rojava and the Rojava revolution. And that, I think, is also related to the tradition that the Italian left has known after the struggle of the Zapatista movement also, which is more related to the autonomy,
yes.
you know?
Yeah. Because as you know, there has been also an academic research about the similarities between the Zapatista movement and the movement in the northern Kurdistan. Have you seen
that? Yeah, I've seen, And also
by Gambetti.
Yeah. And also we start to see which are the differences between this movement and also which are the commonalities between the autonomous system, which are autonomous non-state related movement, yes, the way of organization.
And right now, what are the Italian organizations or social movements they are concretely doing right now in Rojava in general?
Okay, so
because you know now the situation becomes very tense and it may go to the worse because of this aggression by the Turkish state, as you know.
So we organized several weeks ago a big demonstration, massive rally in Rome, which was related mostly to the aggression of Mr. Erdogan to the Kurds, people in Kurdistan, Bagur. But now we are starting again to denounce what is happening in Rojava, and not just the attack of Daesh to the Kurds people in Rojava, but also the attacking of the Turkish military army to the canton of Rojava.
Yes.
So now we are going to organize more demonstration about that, but also we are continuing to support of about with humanitarian aid to the people of Rojava.
Yeah. And then for the Rojava Day on the 1st of November?
Yeah, for November we are thinking to organize several demonstrations, not just one massive demonstration, but to spread across the country the words about Rojava Revolution and to denounce what is happening now.
Okay, thank you very much, Alessio, for your participation. Thank you. Binerani Khoshevich, Tamashakaren Heja, Mivani Sehameme, برز لابروس کالینوس برز لامپروس لامپ بله بله بینران این هجا تماشاکر این هجا میوان سهم ما برز لابروس کالینوس که بخوی یونانیه لقبرس را میوان مانه لقبرس آزاد را هاتیه انگلک بخیر بی you are very welcome to our program Mr. Kallenos. I wanted to ask you something or to draw your attention about something about today, because today, as you know, there is a very big aggression by Turkish army and its gang. I mean, the groups that are really supported by Turkish army today. I mean, the day that we are recording this program, this solidarity program with Kobani. So Mr. Erdogan, which is the president of Turkey, he was in Bursa, and he, in Bursa he said many new things that maybe the Westerners should hear it. He said that the West is not acting correctly. The Western countries use their vast resources not for assisting the oppressed, but to keep them outside the borders. So he means the immigrants or those who have been silenced about the death of more than 600,000 people defend the terrorist PYD. So this is the words of somebody who everybody knows what he has done, what his regime has done during the past, both for instance in the people against the people of Cyprus and later on in recent years against the so-called own citizens inside Turkey. So as a citizen of Cyprus, I wanted to know that what is the motivation of your solidarity with the Kurds of Rojava?
First, for us, for those people who help the Kurdish movement, it is a matter of principle. We think every people who fights for freedom and democracy should be helped, should be offered help and support. And so we start from this.
Yeah.
We believe that the Kurdish people is has been deprived their rights. They are, even their identity is not recognized, much more their right to govern themselves. History, historical circumstances has brought things in this way. We have another common thing with the Kurdish people. We face the same aggression, the same oppressor, the Turkish army, who since 1974 is occupying one third of Cyprus, of yes. Cyprus.
Yeah.
This unavoidably brings us more close to each other. So we start from a general support as to everybody who makes a struggle for liberation and democracy. And then we also have this common situation.
And then your outlook vis-a-vis the people, the citizens of Cyprus, is the same. I mean, you don't differentiate between yourself and the Turkish people, Turkish-speaking people in Cyprus.
I don't know exactly how, but I think they should.
Yeah.
Our Turkish Cypriots or compatriots, I think it is also their duty.
Yes.
To support the Kurdish movement.
No, I mean just the Kurdish movement aside, but I mean I wanted to know about your outlook, because your outlook for supporting the Kurdish cause in, let's say, Rojava or in Kurdistan in general or in northern Kurdistan, so it comes from a kind of motivated by a, let's say, humanistic point of view,
an internationalistic
point of view, but at the same time, this problem that exists in Cyprus. You don't see it from a kind of ethnical question, no? How do you interpret that?
No, it doesn't start from that.
Yeah.
Only in the it is unavoidable that we know we cannot avoid it. We have the same army who invades Cyprus, and the same army also makes war in North Kurdistan.
Yes.
And now they have invaded Syria and Iraq.
Yeah.
It is unavoidable to have this aspect.
And you know,
The one doesn't delete that we must have an international stance of support to the Kurdish people.
Yeah, if you just continue with this issue once, I mean, people say that, for instance, you mentioned now the Iraqi, the Turkish army has penetrated the trampled upon the territorial integrity of Iraq for many years. I mean, they have been stationed somewhere near Mosul. And now Iraqi government openly said that it is not with the satisfaction of the Iraqi government. The Western powers, for instance, Americans says that everything which is done in Iraq, it must be with the consent, with the approval of the Iraqi central government. And many people, when it comes to this point, so they give the problem or the example of Cyprus. They say the Turkish army, whenever they go, they don't come out. Is it true?
In our case, it is true. The Turkish occupation continues.
Yes.
In 1960, they were given the right to intervene in Cyprus. It was called a guarantor right. And by Cyprus before was a colony of the British.
Yes.
There was a struggle for union with the rest of Greece.
Yes.
The struggle didn't succeed, so the colonialists imposed an independence. They forced the people to become another state.
Yes.
And in this new state, Greece, Turkey and Britain, they were given the right to intervene.
Yeah.
They were named guarantor powers.
Guarantor powers, yes.
And in 1974, there was, we think it was a joint, it was a plan.
Okay.
Greek junta make a coup and Turkey invaded.
So if you come back to Kobani and Rojava, how is the solidarity campaign, solidarity movement in Cyprus vis-a-vis Rojava and Kobani?
We try to inform people what is happening.
When did you started your movement? When it was started?
Since before 1980s,
yeah.
In 1987 maybe.
Uh-huh. It was generally with the Kurdish movement, yeah?
Yes, yes, yeah. Of course. perhaps you are aware about Theophilos Georgiadis.
Yeah.
He was the president of a solidarity committee.
Yeah.
And he was killed by Turkish agents in March 94.
Yeah.
There was this this effort to inform the Cypriot people about Kurdistan and to make more stronger relations. So we continue after the Rojava Revolution, because it is a revolution in Rojava. I am not satisfied with what we do. Yeah. I'm not satisfied with the results, but we continue to...
So people from your society, from your association, have they been visiting Rojava? Have been there? No. Okay.
Not yet. Yes.
And what are you doing, I mean, concretely? Are you doing some kind of, let's say, solidarity work or informing, for instance, political parties in Cyprus?
Yes.
What are you doing, I mean, concretely?
There is also a bureau of the Kurdish
Rojava
party in Cyprus.
Yes.
PYD.
PYD, yes.
And
PYD.
They have PYD.
Yes.
And they have contacts with all the political parties and,
yes,
and the government. Every few months they make a
actually
a
not
meeting.
Before long PYD had its the PYD's European organization. They have their eighth conference in,
yes,
Brussels,
yes,
and there was some representative,
yes,
from the Cyprus.
I think members of the,
yeah,
European Parliament,
yes,
participated.
Yes, yeah,
indeed, we have this support and these relations.
Yes.
We hope to organize something more permanent, a kind of committee,
yeah,
which will make proposals to the people of Cyprus. They will visit Rojava and collect, perhaps collect help and bring it to Rojava, such things. I wanted that the people of Cyprus were the first.
Yeah.
Among all the countries who support Kurdistan, because of our common situation. This should have brought each other, our people, more close to Kurdistan, but it's not like this.
Yeah, do you know, I just referred to this book before, but in this book there are very interesting references, I mean, because, as you said, I mean, the Kobani concept, it's a new concept that it's going beyond all borders, you know? Somebody has written here something that really Kobani, I don't know where is Kobani, he says, but anyhow, I don't take your time for that, but I want you to continue to tell me, what are you going to do for this, in the occasion of Kobani Day on 1st of November? What is the planning of your society?
We have organized one event,
yes,
in the ceasefire line,
yeah,
because Cyprus is divided.
Yes, now.
In,
yeah,
Lefkosia,
yeah,
in the capital, there, yeah, is one checkpoint because Lefkosia is divided.
Yeah.
In the Lidra Palace checkpoint, We invited people, representatives from the political parties, from syndicates, from organizations, professors and artists and other public persons. We asked them to come there and say their stand related to Kobani.
Yeah.
We hope they will answer and they will come. And later we will continue to, we hope to start a more permanent committee related,
yeah,
to Kobani.
Yeah. So if you say something, if you like to say, I have no other questions, but if you want to add something to your contributions.
Until now, I feel our information for the people of Cyprus was very weak.
Yeah.
We hope to do more in the future. We are, even geographically, we are so close twice the length of,
yeah,
Cyprus. You go to Kobani,
yeah,
it's so close. But our political parties and the government represents, and the radios, the press in Cyprus, represents the situation as something different.
Yeah.
They don't relate to each other. They understand, they know it is related, if not for any other reason, just for the situation, because it is so close.
Yeah.
But they keep referring to that something else is happening in Cyprus, something else is happening in Syria and Rojava.
Yeah.
This is not a correct way to...
Okay.
And it's not good even for us, because,
yeah,
they make political political line,
yeah,
what to do in Cyprus, what to expect, what they can do, without taking in consideration the possibilities that there is another struggle, there is a whole war next to us.
Okay. Thank you very much indeed for your participation. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you for inviting me.
Thank you. Hello, good afternoon to you. You are welcome to my program. Joe Deleu. So you are a member of the Solidarity Committee in Belgium.
Yeah.
So can you describe your committee a little?
Yes, je parlais.
You can speak French.
French.
Yes, of course.
Nous sommes un comité d'une trentaine de personnes maintenant qui sont.
30 people.
Yes.
Yeah.
Qui sont le noyau de ce comité.
Yeah.
Et qui se sont trouvés par différents biais, c'est des syndicalistes, c'est des intellectuels, c'est quelques étudiants qui se trouvent ensemble parce que la question de Kobani les interpellait spécifiquement.
Yes.
Et donc on a commencé à développer une réflexion d'abord sur la compréhension de ce qui se passait.
Yes.
Et on a aussi essayé de faire connaître la question kurde en Belgique même. Parce qu'on a une
communauté kurde en Belgique,
en Belgique qui est assez important, mais qui est quand même encore isolée de la vie politique et de la vie des gens.
So your committee, concretely, what you have done for Kobani or Rojava?
Yes.
What, concretely, yeah. Very concrete.
Nous avons organisé quelques débats donc dans les différentes villes.
Yes.
Qui ont eu assez de succès.
Yes.
Donc, on a eu quelques meetings aux universités, par exemple,
yes,
pour expliquer la question de Kobani au niveau des principes.
Yeah, I think in, du projet. It was in May 2016 that Jeanette Bill was here. She was in a free university.
À l'ULB. À l'ULB.
Yes, and your committee, you were very actively involved.
Yes.
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Mais il y a eu d'autres universités, il y a Saint-Louis, qui est, l'un était une université laïque et l'autre c'était une université jésuite, par exemple.
Yes.
Donc on essaye, de, dans différents milieux, de lancer le débat.
Yes.
Alors, ce qu'on veut faire maintenant, c'est qu'on a écrit une brochure
yes,
pour, parce qu'on veut lancer l'idée d'aider à la construction d'une école à Kobani, quand il y a la situation rend ça possible, évidemment.
So, have you tried to send medical equips, medical teams to Kobani?
Yes, on a fait ça, mais il y avait eu un problème. On a fait ça avec un mouvement de femmes près de la côte,
yes,
qui était plutôt un mouvement de femmes libéral, pas très socialiste,
yes,
mais qui était très touché par la question au niveau humanitaire.
Yes.
Et elles ont essayé, mais ça a été un peu bloqué. Il y a eu des difficultés pratiques, mais ça continue.
I think there were a group. They wanted to go there
sont allées aussi,
through
oui,
southern Kurdistan, but they were stopped.
C'est ça.
But they don't. They didn't try to go there anymore.
Yes, yes, yes. Ça continue. Le groupe continue. On a des contacts avec eux et ça continue.
Okay. And now, if we come to the media in Belgium.
Yeah. Yes.
According to your impression, what is the, I mean, how the media is taking the question of Kobani, the question of Rojava? As you know, there is also, let's say, a representative of Rojava here, also in Belgium. What is the media? I mean, is it reflected correctly in the media?
No, je crois que ce qu'on a déjà, c'est dans les émissions, les nouvelles.
Yes.
Il y a la question de soldats femmes
yes,
qui est mise en avant,
mm,
mais d'une façon un peu spectaculaire et
yes,
pas très liée au projet de Kobani même.
Mm-hmm.
Mais donc, il y a une certaine sympathie,
yes,
mais qui ne va pas assez profondément.
Enough.
C'est pas enough.
Yes.
Donc, c'est ça qu'on doit faire.
Yes.
Donc, ce qu'on planifie maintenant, par exemple, c'est au début novembre, c'est une grande conférence avec deux personnes qui viennent de Kobani
yes,
et un philosophe belge
yes,
qui s'appelle Pierre Ancet, qui est un philosophe assez connu, c'est un auteur qui a publié beaucoup de livres sur la vie quotidienne et l'aliénation et un nouveau projet de société.
Mm-hmm.
C'est un monsieur qui est vraiment un philosophe, qui s'occupe de Spinoza
yes,
et qui va étudier la question de Kobani
yeah,
comme exemple philosophique aussi, pour construire une nouvelle idéologie, comprendre ce qu'une société peut être, qu'un autre type de vie quotidienne peut être.
It's very, really, it's very good news because there are very famous world renowned academics who are very much interested in Rojava. Yeah. And one of them actually has visited Rojava. He's, I think, a professor in one of the most important universities in Britain. I mean, so it's very important that every academic will be interested. What are you going to do for the 1st of November, for the International
But
Kobani
we have
Day?
We have a reception in the Parliament. On a reception au Parlement avec le Parti social-démocrate.
Yes.
Et donc ils accueillent le mouvement kurde là pour un peu fêter, réfléchir cette journée-là. Mais nous, on veut faire cette conférence en fait début novembre pour.
And on the level of the let's say the cooperation between the different solidarity groups in different European countries, what do you think? In what way they can be more in touch in order to publicize the issue?
Yeah, c'est pas assez développé. On doit vraiment organiser des réunions internationales.
In what way it could be developed? In what way?
Bah, on doit
effectively.
Oui, il faut commencer à réunir les représentants des comités. Il faut une réunion parce qu'on entend des choses. On sait par les nouvelles qu'il y a eu des manifestations ou des, mais on se voit pas les organisateurs. Et donc on doit se réunir une fois et coordonner quelques actions qui seront répercutées alors plus structurellement.
Yeah.
Et ça aura une autre audience au niveau européen, je crois, si c'est plus coordonné. C'est possible, je crois. On attend ça un peu.
Okay.
Je voudrais
dire
quelque chose parce que moi, je suis en fait pas francophone.
Yeah.
Belge, mais je suis flamande belge.
Yes.
Et en Flandre, on a aussi une question nationale.
Of course, yes.
Mais la question nationale en Flandre est surtout reprise par la droite.
Yes.
Parce que chez nous, en Flandre, la social-démocratie n'était pas assez intéressée dans la question du peuple au niveau de sa langue, de son enseignement.
Let me explain for our viewers. Rassida ou Miwane Barizaman Basi. There was a زماني دك على ولاتي بلجيك دلها من استاك بفرنسا قصده كم من فرنسيين بخم زمانم فلامية يا فلاميش وزارك وكو هولندي وباسي جاوازي أوانا دك and I think you have also German language.
Yes.
You have three official languages. Yeah. Yes.
Après la deuxième guerre mondiale, il y a une partie qui oui.
Please continue.
Ce qui manquait chez nous dans cette question, c'est qu'il n'y avait pas de lien entre la question sociale, donc l'émancipation des travailleurs et la souveraineté du peuple, pas la souveraineté de la nation.
Yeah.
Et, il y avait donc la scission entre la question culturelle et la question sociale. Et vous donnez l'exemple que la question nationale peut être posée complètement différente. C'est pour ça que c'est terriblement intéressant à ce niveau-là aussi.
Especially in the level of language.
Because level of
language. Yes, you have different varieties.
Yeah.
But the people, they may identify themselves of Kurds, but sometimes the varieties are like that they may not understand each other.
Yes.
But everybody identifies itself or herself as Kurds.
Yeah. 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 Donc c'est une façon de voir les choses qui est très intéressant.
Yes.
Mais pour nous, pour le comité, pour les gens qui travaillent, l'exemple Kobani, c'est surtout le lien entre la question sociale, le socialisme et la révolution. Qui est vu d'une façon de démocratie radicale.
Démocratie radicale and democracy from the beneath. I mean.
Voilà.
Yes. Not from above.
Voilà, complètement. Yeah. Ça, c'est très stimulant pour réfléchir de nouveau parce que, en fait, en Europe, on a connu l'échec de la révolution. Et donc, ça nous donne aussi un espoir, même si c'est dans une situation évidemment très pénible à ce moment-ci parce que
Do you see this model as a hope for the leftist movement
Absolument.
In Europe?
Absolument.
In the world?
Je crois que ça attire d'ailleurs beaucoup de jeunes.
Yeah.
C'est une nouvelle façon d'entrer dans l'engagement pour les luttes émancipatrices.
Okay. Thank you very much indeed. Thank you. بینران خوشویست میوانی پیش اوی که میوانی دیکه به ام پیم خوش بو که اگر بکره لره شعرک بخون مو اگر بتوانم بیبین مو بلا همو نخون مو تنکیو او شعری شاعری کی ترکه بنوی محمود جان تکین به ترکیشه دیاره هر کپلی که لده خون مو دلی بگن بایرام گنلوم گزوم سنده دیر Ümit gölü diren canım Kobani. Yürek sende, inanç gözüm sendedir. Kır çemberi, şeref şanım Kobani. You are most welcome.
Bonsoir.
It was a little poetry by a Turkish poet about the Kobani. Mr. Mr. Jean-Pierre Docorps, you are most welcome. You are a computer scientist,
yeah.
But you have been in solidarity, engaged in solidarity with the Kurdish movement. Can you tell me a little about your engagement, your solidarity?
It's not
true. En français, you can
speak. Ce n'est pas vraiment un engagement.
Yeah, no. Yeah.
J'ai découvert
yeah.
Les écrits d'Öcalan, de Monsieur Öcalan.
Yeah.
Et j'ai découvert le confédéralisme démocratique. Mm-hmm. Je ne suis pas de gauche, je ne suis pas de droite, je suis un individu.
Yeah.
Et en lisant le confédéralisme démocratique d'Öcalan, mm-hmm. j'ai entendu parler du Rojava et j'ai voulu vérifier que c'était possible.
Yeah.
Et donc j'ai décidé d'aller au Rojava, et j'ai passé un mois au Rojava, parcouru le Rojava dans ce qui était possible de le parcourir, interrogé des responsables politiques, interrogé des gens du peuple, et j'ai vu fonctionner le confédéralisme démocratique. Yeah. Je l'ai vu de mes yeux vus.
You know, you are coming from a country, it's France.
France.
And in France, you have a very big company, it's called Eutelsat, which recently started to block some of the facilities that some of the Kurdish televisions they had there, and even one of the televisions which still is working and it's sending its programming streaming for Rojava, mm-hmm. it's called Runahi TV, even they want to silence the Runahi TV under the, let's say, pressure by a mm-hmm. organization from Turkey, which is very openly, they ask this, let's say, company like Eutelsat to silence the Kurdish voice there. You as a, let's say, which are solidarity,
yes.
show your solidarity with the Kurds there. Mm. In what way you can just try to, I mean, defend the rights of the Kurds to information?
First, en utilisant les réseaux sociaux, mm-hmm. j'ai beaucoup de followers mm-hmm. sur Twitter. Mm-hmm. Je fais souvent des reportages sur les manifestations kurdes. Et j'ai participé aux dernières manifestations contre Telsat.
Yes.
Et en fait, tout passe par les réseaux sociaux. Il y a une grosse communauté kurde en France et un gros soutien de tous les partis de gauche, mm-hmm. Que ce soit côté Mélenchon, côté NPA, tous ces partis-là yeah. supportent le mouvement kurde.
You know, because there are very, really, it's very paradoxical, you know, on one hand, for instance, the, let's say, the leaders, the representatives of Rojava, they are very officially welcomed in France. Even they have, they had the audience with the president of the mm-hmm. France, Mr. Hollande, and they have received very warmly. And on the other hand, a company tries to just, to cut the voice of the people. I mean, it's very paradoxical.
Non, c'est le libéralisme.
Yeah.
Une société, l'État, une société, elle fait ce qu'elle veut, à condition qu'elle n'enfreigne pas des droits constitutionnels ou le droit à la légalité. Mm-hmm. Et il se trouve que Eutelsat va être attaqué en procès, et c'est les juges qui diront si elle avait le droit de couper, il semble, c'est 50-50. Yeah. On ne sait pas trop le résultat, yeah. mais Eutelsat va être attaqué en justice.
Okay, yeah. If we go back to your, you said that you have been working on the works of Mr. Öcalan, but in as a collective, what are your, let's say, solidarity work? is shaping towards the Rojava?
Alors, ma solidarité, c'est d'agir, mm-hmm. c'est de vouloir agir, et donc de vouloir aller au Rojava.
Yeah.
Je retournerai au Rojava pour vivre au Rojava
yeah.
jusqu'à la fin de ma vie,
yeah.
et essayer d'enseigner et d'apporter mes connaissances. Je veux travailler pour la reconstruction du Rojava.
Yeah.
Je veux travailler pour la paix au Rojava. Mm.
Working with reconstruction in what way?
With my knowledge.
Yes. You mean computer?
Computer, yes. Mathématiques et yeah. épidémiologie, yes. La santé.
So you have this planning to go and have some ways teach there or?
Je peux pas savoir quand exactement puisque je suis en train de faire okay. un travail en France.
Yes.
Je peux pas en parler.
Yeah.
Certainement l'année prochaine ou dans un an et demi, je pense à partir vivre définitivement au Rojava.
Okay. And what about the 1st November, the International Kobani Day? What message do you have?
J'ai eu au téléphone la responsable du centre culturel à Paris.
Yeah.
Et elle m'a dit que les préparatifs étaient en cours et qu'ils allaient se passer ce qui s'était déjà passé l'année dernière, puisqu'ils l'ont déjà fait l'année dernière.
Yeah.
Et il va y avoir des manifestations artistiques et ainsi de suite. Donc ça va bien se passer. Voilà.
OK, thank you very much indeed for your participation. Thank you. Thank you. تماشاگرین برز نوها میوانی که دنیای می فرانسوی هست که بخو روزنامه‌وان و ژورنالیست برز که رافائل لبوژه که ما زور خوشحالیم که بجداری کرد ولیره. You are most welcome to our special show for solidarity with Kobani, really to commemorating the 4th year of Kobani Day. You are very welcome.
Spas.
Okay, tell me about yourself. What kind of journalist are you?
J'ai découvert le Rojava en 2013
yeah.
et j'ai remarqué qu'il y a très peu d'informations dans la presse mm-hmm. sur le Rojava en France.
Yeah.
Tout mon problème à partir de là, c'est comment on informe les gens en France pour qu'ils sachent ce qui se passe vraiment. Parce que mm-hmm. les rares articles yeah. qui étaient écrits, il y avait énormément de désinformation mm-hmm. dans les grands médias.
Yeah.
Et à partir de là, donc, j'ai fait un travail de recherche
yes.
Très poussé mm-hmm. pour connaître en fait, le fonctionnement du Rojava. J'ai étudié Abdul Jalan, le confédéralisme démocratique mm-hmm. Et l'histoire du Kurdistan.
Yeah.
Et à partir de là, j'ai écrit de nombreux articles.
Where in Rojava? Where
you were? Je suis allé au Rojava.
Yeah.
Oui, je suis allé au Rojava. Alors, j'ai voyagé au Rojava, donc je suis allé à Ramishlo, à Tel Tamer,
yeah.
À Serekanié, à Girelspi, à Kobané, beaucoup de villes, Derek aussi,
yes.
pour voir comment ça se passait au niveau local
okay.
et comment les assemblées fonctionnaient.
So, what did you see in Kobani exactly?
Qu'est-ce que je peux dire sur Kobané?
Yes.
Kobané, en fait, quand je suis arrivé, c'était une des conditions très difficiles.
Mm-hmm.
C'est-à-dire que les gens n'avaient pas d'électricité, la Turquie avait coupé l'électricité, il n'y avait pas de moyens, très peu de moyens sur place. Par exemple, une personne était blessée, elle devait aller jusqu'à Ramishlo pour mm-hmm. se faire soigner dans des cas graves. Et les gens ne savaient pas, connaissent pas les conditions de Kobané qui sont terribles, par exemple. Ils ne connaissent pas cet aspect des choses. On parle souvent des questions militaires quand
yeah.
on parle de Rojava. Le problème, c'est qu'on ne parle pas de la solution politique qu'ils proposent. Et Kobané, les gens s'organisaient
mm-hmm.
pour reconstruire la ville. C'était l'auto-administration de la ville.
So you said that you were, just as you mentioned now, you were studying how the people locally they are functioning. What about your contacts with local journalists? Did you meet any journalists, any Kurdish from Kobani?
Alors, le problème des journalistes
yeah.
que je connaissais, alors surtout des internationaux,
yeah.
Quand je suis rentré à Derik, enfin quand je suis arrivé pas à Derik mais à Simalka,
yeah.
à Simalka j'ai rencontré le premier journaliste,
mm-hmm.
je lui ai dit qu'est-ce que tu connais du Rojava?
Yeah.
Il m'a parlé des questions militaires et je lui ai dit mais le système du Rojava, comment il fonctionne? Il m'a dit je ne sais pas.
Yeah.
C'est-à-dire qu'en fait, les journalistes qui sont envoyés sur place le sont surtout pour suivre la situation militaire
mm-hmm.
et non pas suivre les questions politiques
yeah.
qui se jouent. Et il y a un problème d'information en sein même des journalistes.
Yeah. You said that you have also studied a bit of history about Kurdish history or history of Kurdistan. And you know that there is also a kind of colonial contact between France and Kurdistan. Mm. For instance, especially on Rojava. Can you tell me a little about it? Is it still, I mean, for instance, I remember when the first, one of the first Kurdish institutions was established in France, the Kurd Institute de Paris.
Oui.
They said once upon a time, there has been a France Institute de Damas.
Mm. Yeah. Oui, so, yeah. Oui, il y a une longue relation d'histoire entre la Syrie et donc de fait aussi les Kurdes. Il y avait, il y avait d'ailleurs sur place une longue histoire de conflits entre les Arabes et les Kurdes sous la colonisation. Des Kurdes, par exemple, ont combattu certains rebelles arabes parce qu'ils considéraient que c'était de nouveaux colonisateurs. Donc sur place, aujourd'hui, il y a des liens qui se développent de nouveau. Yeah. Par exemple, il y a un institut français du Rojava qui se construit actuellement à Amouda, donc dans la ville d'Amouda, pour justement faire des échanges culturels. Il y a aussi une université au Rojava qui s'est jumelée avec l'université en France de Paris 8.
Okay.
Voilà. Donc les liens se rôtissent, mais sauf que cette fois-ci, ça va être, je veux que ce soit des liens à égalité, que ce ne soit pas des liens de colonisateur à colonisé, c'est-à-dire un échange égalitaire.
So I think I asked this question from another guest tonight, but I'm asking you this as well. What in what way do you think that this solidarity work among people from different European countries can be strengthened, more contacts? For instance, this opportunity, this is I think the first opportunity that people from different countries, they have who are interest to solidarize themselves with the cause in Kobani or in Rojava, they can come together and have some kind of exchange views and things like that. In what way do you think it should be developed, could be developed?
Alors, hier, j'étais dans une réunion où les gens qui sont venus aider au Rojava se sont rassemblés pour justement savoir comment on peut soutenir le Rojava. Et sur cette réunion, on s'est mis d'accord qu'il faut construire une organisation commune des gens, des Européens qui soutiennent le Rojava pour qu'on puisse se coordonner, pour que les gens qui arrivent là-bas sachent comment faire, comment aider, quelles sont les solutions possibles. Comment soutenir, comment ramasser du matériel. Par exemple, il y a plusieurs personnes en France qui essayent d'envoyer du matériel médical au Rojava à cause de l'embargo, qui est le premier problème qu'on rencontre là-bas. Très peu de personnes peuvent avoir accès au Rojava. Et donc, organiser les liens européens de soutien au Rojava est une priorité, tout comme informer.
Yes. And now, in France, you have, I suppose you have close contact with the representative of Rojava there? Because recently it was opened in France as well.
Yes, j'étais à l'ouverture de l'office du Rojava en France récemment. Il y avait beaucoup de monde. J'étais étonné, il y avait Bernard Kouchner, par exemple, qui est venu, une personnalité française. Patrick Franceschi, qui est un vieux soutien.
Patrick Franceschi was recently also participating in the conference of PYD in Brussels. Mm. And he gave a solidarity speech.
Oui.
Yes, which was very, very strong speech. Yes.
Oui, il s'est beaucoup mobilisé.
Yes.
Il y a d'autres personnes qui aujourd'hui commencent à se mobiliser. De plus en plus de gens en France commencent à prendre conscience que c'est la seule alternative viable pour la Syrie et le Moyen-Orient en général. Et je pense qu'il faut que des gens, de plus en plus de gens et de personnalités commencent à franchir le pas.
So you, one of these television stations, for instance, Runahi TV, which is sending for Rojava, they have a weekly program in French language.
Yes.
Yes. Right. Do you think that it has some audience among the French speakers in France?
Alors, j'aimerais, en fait, cette télé est très peu connue, alors que c'est une bonne télé d'information. Et j'espère, enfin.
Because you can see it online as well. I mean, if you don't need to have any satellite, you can see it online.
Online?
Online, and you can see it on computer.
Ah,
if you like.
Pour.
Yes, the program.
Ah.
Yes.
Ah.
Yes, it's possible. Yes.
Ah, oui, ça serait, ça serait génial.
So I think next time when you are talking to people, you can also speak about this program because the benefit with the program is that you can get the new actualities, the information from Rojava.
Mm, yes. Oui, oui.
So, if we come back to the solidarity work and the Kobani Day, what is the plan of the movement there in France for the Kobani Day on 1st of November?
Alors, il va y avoir des mobilisations Donc déjà au niveau européen, mais en France, il y a une grosse communauté kurde avec qui je travaille, qui donc va organiser des manifestations, des événements, des conférences. J'invite les gens à participer un maximum pour le succès de ces événements. Bien sûr, moi, je pense que je vais écrire des articles sur cette question pour aider.
Is there enough literature in French about this new experiment in Rojava? Enough literature, enough writings in French language.
Ah oui, oui.
For instance, is the works of Öcalan, the works of Bookchin,
les translations
of Jeanette Bill, are they translated into French?
Alors, pour ce qui est de Jeanette Bill, il y a le Municipalisme libertaire qui a été traduit, que j'ai lu, qui est un bon livre d'information sur les idées de Bookchin, qui réunit et qui résume ce qui se passe. De Öcalan, il faudrait qu'il y ait plus de textes, mais le texte le traduit que je connais, que c'est le Confédéralisme démocratique, le résumé. Et il y a aussi un livre sur les femmes, donc sur le Rojava. Et Murray Bookchin, il y a de nouvelles traductions qui sont en train d'être sorties. Et le dernier, c'est Au-delà de la rareté, c'est sur ses idées écologiques et ses propositions pour une société alternative pour le futur.
Ok, thank you very much for your time, Raphael. Thank you.
Spas.
Thank you. Mivani Barezman. Nice to meet you, Cengiz. Mivani Barezman, Rezar Cengiz Kulaca, că buhoi la ulati Autriș, la ulati Nemsara hatua, wa cealaka la fondacioni la Green Foundation, ya binyati skas, că wabzam rechisneke că bu mesele ecologii o anacardeka. You are most welcome to our special program. So I spoke a little in Kurdish about Green Foundation. Could you tell me what's Green Foundation in Austria?
The Green Foundation is an organization which is committed to educating people. In political education. So it's about bringing awareness to activists, to politicians, to civil society. So, and we also are committed to bring awareness to people about Rojava and the Kurdish situation in general, the Turkish Turkish politics on the Kurdish question, and we support also civil society organizing events on their own.
So I know that recently, I mean in the past 3-4 months or even maybe a bit longer, so there was much discussion there because I think there is a Turkish community there and there is a Kurdish community and there was also there is a Green Party representative in the parliament who has some Kurdish connection. So I think even the state or the government was involved in that. So how is the difficulties for solidarity work with the Kurds in general and the people of Rojava in particular in Austria?
Well, we try to be very concrete and try to help people, give them facilities to organize. I think there is a long history in Austria with of solidarity with the Kurdish movement. To the current situation, the government is in this conflict between the far right and kind of coping with the situation of refugees. And it has a long history of refugees from Kurdistan and has a long history of also Turkish immigration. So we have different political groups fighting in the streets sometimes. Especially the Green Party is there to bring awareness that Turkish fascists, for instance, are attacking Kurdish restaurants and institutions and associations. And we try to provide help and legal help. We try to bring awareness to the situation. And the solidarity in general to Rojava, we have founded a solidarity committee were different political organizations, different left-wing organizations, social democrats, greens, socialists, different ecological movements come together and organize demonstrations, organize charity to get money to build up Kobani again.
Yeah. Have there been people there in already? I mean, have been people from Austria traveling to Kobani or to Rojava?
Yes, there are of course scientists. One of a famous scientist, political scientist, wrote a book about Rojava, yes, about the revolution and the war in the region.
Is it the lady who is based in Norway?
Or it's not. No. It's Thomas Schmieding.
Yes, I know. Yes, I know. Thomas. Yes.
And he's doing a lot of solidarity. Yeah. We had book presentations with him, yes, about the region.
Actually, he was in a conference in the European Parliament. I think it was in the beginning of May. There was a conference about a special Kurdish community, Feli Kurds.
Yeah.
He writes about them as well. He was in this conference. Anyhow, we'll continue, please.
Yes, so, and this, He presented images and pictures of his travels to
Parliament, and then
the Turkish government was protesting against that. He took pictures. I mean, this is a bit crazy.
Though. Yes.
So that is one thing, to do intellectual work and support making awareness in the public, but also organizing solidarity in the sense of helping refugees, helping, because we have a lot of Kurdish refugees.
So what do you do practically? I mean, as you know, the Kurdish movement, especially in the north and in Rojava, this is differentiate it like that. So it's not an ethnic, it's not basing its policies on ethnicity.
Yeah.
I mean, you can talk any language, but as long as you solidarize with Kobani and accept the or respect the will of the people, doesn't matter where you are born or something.
Yeah.
So how, in what way do you de-escalate these, for instance, ethnical tension in Austria? I mean, it doesn't mean that everybody who speaks Kurdish is a angel. It's not the same as a Turk, but everybody could be bad and good among others. In what way you are working with that?
There is one key distinction one has to make. One is ethnicity.
Yes.
And the other is ideology.
Yes.
And it does not matter where you come from, but it's the way you think. How you see humanity. What you think how humans are, and that humans have good potential and very bad potential.
Yes.
So within the Turkish community, there are progressive people who are supporting the freedom of Kurdish people, autonomy.
The example was that poetry that I wanted to read it through.
Exactly. Yes. And for instance, HDP as a party is an example of that. Yeah, that it has a Turkish leadership and a Kurdish leadership.
Yeah.
That's also what we do. We went to the Kurdish region in the Turkish state when there was election, and I did in Bitlis, for instance. Yeah. I observed the election. I wrote articles in Austrian newspaper that there were tanks just right in front of ballot offices. There was psychological warfare at the election day in Turkey, for instance, and we are working also on that. So, in a broader sense, there are different ways to engage in solidarity.
So, apart from the Green Foundation and the Green Party, which is in the Austrian Parliament, the other established political parties or the social movements, what's their reaction and their way of showing their solidarity with the movement in the Rojava?
Sometimes it happens that that it's misused by the far right because the fight against jihadism is sometimes instrumentalized for racism. That's one thing. That's the far right. But we try to separate it totally. We are anti-fascists, and we understand the fight against jihadism as an anti-fascist cause.
Yes.
So that's not a true. What the far right is doing is not a true support of the freedom of women, of minorities. And then there is the social democracy, which has historically been very supportive in the European context also.
I think the ex-president of Austria was a member of the Solidarity Committee with the Kurds.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. So, I mean, also the chair of the parliamentary group of the Social Democrats did call for solidarity, and we have joint video calls by Greens and Social Democrats usually. Yeah. So that's.
So what is your next plan? I mean, we are approaching the 1st of November, the International Kobani Day. What's the practically you are doing to celebrate this day?
Well, first we have simply to state in the Austrian public, that that's a day to celebrate and not to be sad. Yeah. It's though we need to remember those who have been killed, we need to say, okay, we won some freedom here together because of international support. There was also a lot of awareness about that. So that's one thing. Another is we mobilize, as everywhere in Europe, we will have actions in Vienna, in Graz, in other places. On the long-term run, we will continue with doing our educational work and explaining the theories of Bookchin, for instance, also. So when even young Greens read Bookchin, for instance, in Austria. Yes. So.
And I think the literature in German is very rich in this connection, because recently a book about Rojava, which was originally in German language, it was translated into English by Jeanette Biel.
Exactly.
And Jeanette Biel says that because the book was so impressive, that she translated it without deciding to write herself about it. So let me ask you the last question. I put the question to other guests as well about these, let's say, contact between different solidarity groups with Rojava in Europe. What's your perspective about it?
I think what is relevant is the European Union and the institutions of the European Union, especially the European Parliament, to connect different political, especially left-wing groups like the Greens and the Left Party, and have frequently study sessions and events on the issue and negotiate for peace and try and also to have a clear stance on the Islamic State and and a clear stance also towards Turkey and the dirty deal with on refugees and all this stuff.
Let me do some let's say it's not propaganda, but the reality is something for about the Green Movement. I mean, recently there was a congress of PYD, European organizations. In Brussels, there were three member of parliaments from Green Party in Sweden, and they gave a very radical speech, which was unexpected. I mean, for the Northerner from North Europa. So, it seems that the Green Movement are very much engaged in that.
Exactly.
Yes.
Also, one Austrian a member of the European Parliament went to Shingal in 2014, and he was on a helicopter. Filming what's going on, that he was on the last helicopter bringing help to Shingal, and this brought it to the world. I mean, 10 million people saw this video from that back then. YouTube was like, everybody was on YouTube on this. And I think it's very important to have also members of the European Parliament right at the spot to observe what's going on.
Thank you very much, Cengiz.
Thank you. Thank you.
بینرانی خوشویست تماشاگران هجا نها میواندهی دکین قصه دکین دگل برز دگل برز میشل آلیسون که بخوی ارکیتکتا معماری که دلخوازه لکاری که چاریتی دا لولات بریتانیای مزن یا یونایتد کینگدم لرخصنی دا بنوی ریبیلد او وکو بجن ارکیتکتک لو چارچو او رخصنه دا کرده که لپیوندی لگل سولیداریتی و هاو پیوندی لگل خلق روژاوا چند جمله یکی لپیش را به کردی دنگ بکن گل خیر بی بو پروگرامه به کردی برسه بده
زر سپاس شبوی که شانسک دامک امنا ودره project خلاصار كوباني بين سازم.
زو باشا. Now we can switch it into English. Now, could you possibly tell me about this project that you were just mentioned? What's your project about the Kobani as an architect?
Yeah, we are. I'm volunteer as a rebuild charity that we set up in UK.
Rebuild is an organization for
it's a charity
organization.
It's a general charity where we help the countries that that suffered war and destructions, such as Kobani.
Yeah.
And that's how we help people, and then we build and we try to help and fundraise for the four countries. And now we have some projects that we are with Oxfam, that the big charity organization. And some exhibitions, photographic exhibition where...
Could you say also introduce Oxfam as well? I mean, because...
Oxfam is also a very large
charity organization,
where they help international... It's an international charity where they fundraise.
Yes.
It's an established, very old charity, well-known charity. So basically we are setting up like co-work with those big charities because they're well-known. So we can fundraise for Kobani. At the moment we have a school project which I designed. It's an ecological farm school. There's a little farm
in Kobani itself.
Yeah, for Kobani.
Yeah.
And then also we have a playground, ecological playground that is designed for Gizre Canton.
Yes.
And also we have a project ongoing. Just we are starting a project for a women village.
Yeah.
That's for women who are widowed, whose husbands or children or sons are killed. So it's going to be like a women village where women can form cooperatives. They can educate and then build women academies and look after children. And
so
you know,
do you have access to that? Do you can travel freely?
No, we only went to Kobani in 2015 just for a day because we had a big conference in Ahmed.
Yeah.
So we went there and we have met some women when we asked them what kind of help they need. And also we met the administration who told us, you know, basically they have nothing there, no schools, no women administrations, and they need everything. So we have basically, we are working on those projects. And also...
Before you continue with the project, what was the impression of you of the women there? The women who could stay all the time, I mean, during the...
When we went there, Kobani was liberated already. It was May 2015.
Yeah.
Of course, the city was a total destruction.
Yeah.
It was rubble to the ground. And they were very strong and all smiling and much more positive than we can ever imagine. But of course, they were very determined to do something in Kobani because they really defend Kobani very heroically.
Yeah.
And they were like very adamant to seal, rebuild, and I think we owe it to them that we helped them to rebuild this city where they, you know, before the international eye of the international communities, they fight against ISIS. So we asked them what kind of projects they want. They said everything, but then first they wanted some emergency help.
Yes.
Which, I mean, from the Europe, not only from UK, but, you know, it's partly help. So they were like hospitals or clinics and schools and also like, you know, like little workshops where they can create like hygienic stuff and things
but
like that.
But this concrete project of rebuild, could you just elaborate on that, please?
The rebuild is a new, we've been established, it's a new 2 years we've been working on it, but it's been registered as a charity in UK only last week, actually.
Yeah.
It's very difficult in the United Kingdom to get a status of a charity.
Yeah.
But once you get it, then you're a trusted charity.
Yeah.
So now, our friends, we are all working sort of on this, and also we are trying to help women to create a bakery, a cooperative bakery for women, also in Kobani. So we have fundraised a little bit money. It's not too much, but now because we are now charity and we can have the bank account, and now we will work quite because we are thinking of concerts and we are thinking of fundraising, photographic exhibitions.
So are the people from Kurdish community in Great Britain, are they involved in that?
They are,
somehow?
Yeah.
In
They're young Kurdish activists. They're helping with exhibitions. They're putting photos together to create an exhibition where we can fundraise. They are. They did all the registration charities, our lawyers' friends who are volunteering in this. And we are introducing the charities to different charities. I mean, everybody's been working for about 2 years, and a lot of input has been put, but mostly Kurdish people, but other friends as well, so they're helping. So
I mean, if we go back a little about the general situation for the solidarity with Kobani in Britain, as you know, because there have been people there for some voluntarily they have joined Gander, and even some of them they have lost their lives, yes, and things like that. So it may have its impact on the public opinion, I think, in general
in Britain. Yes. I think it's fair to say that Kobani became obviously like a, you know, a defining line for Kurdish. You know, Kurdish liberation, and also for the Kurdish fight against injustice and against the extinction of Kurdish rights and language. So now, for the first time, the people of Britain start to understand who the Kurds really are, mm-hmm, other than they've been portrayed differently by the, you know, by the colonial powers, by Turkey themselves. But now they know what Kurds are fighting for and what they're about. Because what's happened in Rojava, they know it is actually what's happening in North Kurdistan, in Rojhelat, and even in South Kurdistan. So mm-hmm, it's a new model that's been built, and it's not a model that is a terrorist, or it's not a model that is, you know, it's outrageous, but it's a model that is based on grassroots democracy. So even in the most state-sponsored media, you can see the language that is very, you know, there is in solidarity with people. And then of course we had martyrs, British martyrs, Costa, and also we had another martyr, and also we have some YPG volunteers coming back to UK, and they've been actually tried in the court, but they've been found, you know, the court is like successful, and then they've been found not guilty just last week. That was good. So that was actually a point that, you know, British government are not recognizing them as terrorists. Mm-hmm. And so it's in that sense, there is a public support, there's a great public support, because we are invited to public speeches to talk about the model itself,
yes,
about the democratic confederalism, stateless nations, and what's been built in Kobani. And I do a lot of speech about actually Kurdish women revolution, and it's quite new to feminist movements and to the international movements. So you know, it's a lot of it's quite impressive to so many.
You know, in the
sense.
Level of the House of Commons, there was a old party committee just to monitoring the situation in Syria, and one of them was a lady who was a member of Labour Party just before the referendum for mm-hmm. remaining or leaving the European Union. So she lost her life, Joe Cox. I think recently there was a debate in House of Commons about the situation in Syria, but I think there is not enough information for the people, I mean, who are talking about it. I mean, maybe there is not enough information for the people who are engaged in general about the Kurdish issue.
And the politicians, you mean?
You know, I mean, for instance, the member of parliament, yeah, in Britain, and Britain, you know, as a colonial power, and otherwise, for instance, even among the Labour Party, for instance, Mr. Jeremy Corbyn, the present leader,
yeah,
of
the Labour
Party, has been a very long supporting the Kurdish issue in,
yeah,
different parts of Kurdistan. So I was following this debate, but I just sensed like that they have not enough information about the way that resistance has been going on in Rojava.
You see, the people are one thing, and the government and politicians are something else. So I am pretty confident they do know a lot about what's happening.
Yeah.
But of course, it's something that they do not want to recognize, and because it's such an anti-colonial ideology, and it's a very grassroots democracy that is going,
yeah,
on in Rojava, that is totally against the colonial interests, that economic and colonial interests of a country like United Kingdom. And so that's why in the parliament, although they're very well informed, because we have regular meetings with them and we have informed them, they're aware of what's happening in Turkey, in Bakur, on the Cizre, in Nusaybin, but you know, politically, they have their own agenda, and they try to close blind eye to what's happening.
Yeah.
But of course, we have people like Jeremy Corbyn, the progressive people, the, you know, Jill Lambert, like the Green
Party. Green Party, yes.
We have a lot of friends in, yes, Green Party. They are more genuine.
Yeah.
And even one or two probably in the Conservative Party, probably one or two, but they do know. I think it is the solidarity of the people will change the perspective of the governments in every country in Europe,
yes,
but also especially in Britain, because Britain is always...
I think in Britain, in UK's Parliament, in House of Commons, we have also a representative from the town of Shakespeare, who has a Kurdish background.
Oh?
Yes.
I didn't know
this
that.
Is the only parliamentarian who is representing the town of Shakespeare. He comes from Kurdistan originally.
Oh, yes, actually, yes, I've heard, but I don't know much about it, so I'm not going to speak
so it on that one. I think if one tries to reach different people in different levels, so there is the possibility, because British colonialism have been very much engaged in the area, you know,
for many years. That's why it's one of the most difficult countries to pursue in terms of political. Yes. But very interesting, even British people have very great sympathy for what's going on in Kurdistan, especially after Rojava revolution. Yes. So they are
so apart from this charity rebuild, that is a very new organization, what about the other solidarity work among the people in Britain for the Rojava, especially for Kobani?
There are a lot of meetings in all over Britain, in Scotland, in Nottingham, in south of England, as well as London, of course. There are a lot of meetings where they invite people from Rojava or Kurdish communities to talk about Rojava and also to talk about the model. And we have a lot of meetings in the parliament also, the MPs host a room and we, you know, the Kurdish people goes, I mean, the Kurdish politician, they're invited in and they talk about overall in Kurdistan and about Rojava and also about women. So there's a lot of work. Lot of work goes on in Britain in that sense. And also even some of the families of the martyrs, the British martyrs, they always, in the social media, they're always doing this kind of fundraising, awareness raising.
Actually, they were also in the meeting of PYD Brussels.
They came. They spent so much time, and that's very important. Also some of the ex-people that, you know, the people who went to Kobani and came back, they are continuing their work to talk about Kobani, you know, in the British public, which is effective, of course.
I heard a few times in the, because I'm just very interested in the politics in Britain, I followed that even in the debate in House of Commons, that some Scottish members of Parliament, so they are also interested in the Kurdish issue, because there are some similarities between Scotland and Kurdistan. So how is the contact with them, with the Scottish Nationalist Party?
SNP. We have very good contact with SNP. Yes. I myself been to some of the meetings with my colleagues. And of course, it is the easiest place in Britain to have, you know, to have solidarity work with Scotland and Ireland also, because they know where we're coming from. They can understand the situation. And they are very supportive, and then there is now, we are trying to create this working group within the Scottish Parliament, and also we are hosting on the in November 22nd, we are hosting a big conference with the HDP and in Scotland as well, and that's going to be very important, because we are basically hundreds of people will be invited to come and listen and talk.
But for the Kobani Day, is it something in
Kobani Day, there's preparation already started. It's kick-started. And then there will be like rallies in all over Britain and London and North Scotland and probably Birmingham. And there will be meetings and seminars. And at the universities, we have a lot of seminars held about the democratic confederalism, about Öcalan's ideology. There are a lot of people very interested in it.
I think in the first week of November, there will be a conference in Sussex University.
Yes.
Janet Beale is going to speak.
Janet Beale is talking, yes. And then Salam Muslim will be coming in November, end of November. He will be in Cambridge University,
And about Oxford. What about the 1st November?
The 1st of November, there are rallies. There are rallies. In London, to celebrate the victory of Kobani for the third year.
Yes.
And to commemorate, of course, all the martyrs that in Kobani. And it is very important, of course, for everyone to own up to what happened in Kobani, because we owe it to the international people who supported and who pushed the governments to actually support from the coalition, because it was the last day when they tried to save the people of Kobani from another massacre, like Cengal itself. Yes. I've heard a real life story, which is like very short, but it's very important that I say it, because I've heard it's really heartbreaking. When the fights were door to door in Kobani, apparently the group of fighters were like strand, and then they were like outgunned and outnumbered, and ISIS was like closing into them, so they were going to be killed. And some of them said, that's it, we are all going to be killed now. And then they kind of want us almost surrender, because there was nothing. They said, the whole world has forgotten about us, and there's nothing, this is the end. And suddenly one of them had the phone, you know, those walkie-talkies they're using. And then he said, Heval, we've heard all over Europe, people are actually supporting us there in the airports, there in the train stations. That they are, everybody's talking about Kobani, yeah. And they're supporting Kobani people. And they were like, he was screaming. And then, you know, this 7-8 people, it was a small group. It was a very small group. And when they heard that, they kind of felt they knew there was a solidarity in, yes, all over the Europe. And, yeah, then they actually stand and they fight back. And actually, they I think there were one or few were killed, but they actually they got themselves out of there, and then they fight against ISIS. Mm. And then they kind of, you know, saved themselves, basically. And I think that is very important. That's why Kobani people says we owe a lot to the international people, to the communities. Yes. And I think we have to own up to this, yes, and we have to continue.
Do you want to say something more about the project? That
Well, the project is one of the charity.
Yeah.
And it is important, of course, we support the charities. It's not only for Kobani, it's a general charity.
Yeah.
But of course, we have a lot of projects to support the Kobani projects. And that's especially about women, school, and children playgroup.
Okay.
Our focus is like first. I mean, we don't have too much money now, yes, but we're first going to be doing those projects,
yes,
and they're all ecologic as well.
Okay.
So we're trying to keep
and
the ecological.
Lastly,
balance.
What's your opinion yourself as well about this solidarity or the closer connection between different solidarity groups in different European capitals, in different European countries?
I think they're very important. Yes. I mean, the solidarity of people is what will be the revolution for revolution. I mean, what would be the victory of a revolution? It being Kobani, being North Kurdistan, being Palestine, anywhere in the world, basically, it's the, when people get together, there is nothing that they can't be, you know, they can't succeed. So I think that would be, that is wanting to push the governments to take the right actions. For example, you know, when we are like pushing our governments that not to support Turkey, and they have to take an action, because, you know, similarly with Kobani, when people were on the street and saying the Kobani people should not be slaughtered all in Cengal. So that's when the government, even though they didn't directly want it, but they had to do it because they need, it was the right thing and it was what the people demanded, especially in Europe, because they still, there's a kind of democracy in Europe and they have to act on the will of the people and the solidarity of people. And I'd say, of course, we have to continue supporting Kobani, and we are part of it and they're part of us. And it is very important, because what happened, the way that ISIS lost in Kobani against people was a very important blown to ISIS, and they still talk about it, because I think if ISIS did not defeat in Kobani, it would be a totally different story right now.
Of course. So we're talking another way.
Yes. So that yeah, totally. We ought to, yes, be talking about something else probably, yes, now. But I think also, of course, everyone that is here today and in Europe has something in it. So thanks to everyone.
Yeah. Thank you very much, you. Michelle. Thank you for your participation. You can say something in your nice Kurdish at the end.
Zor sponsorship bu solidarity channels on Kurdi.
Hamderdi. Hamderdi. Yeah.
Zor sponsorship hamderdi herkesin bu Kobani o
Galaxy Pass.
Galaxy Pass.
Şovaş. Maşallah in heja na miyani ki dine mahaya ku diyare le kari hav pevendi ham fikri ham derdi be khabati Kobani ra mujul bu khabati rojavara. Am be kurmanji deng bikin nul beli. Baş brez Yilmaz te dikari hende ki be gishti li ser au tecrübe xo li ser au kari hav pevendi ku li Europa habu ye ser barat be Kobani ve axivi.
Bele inha beri ku ser va baxum da xast kin çek informasyon der haqe
kerem ke.
Şoreş Kurd li Rojava bu tebeti Kobani bizim berku.
Kerem ke.
Çawa demakum rovled nere bi cihane da gelek guhartını bingeyin hene. Kurna hecda da demam rovled nere taybet şureşe Fransi bir sedemeke le forma nü embejin ne tev devlet. Disa kurna nozdemin emdinerin şureşe sınayi heye endüstriyalizm, teknoloji. Kurna bista emlenlerin şere cihane yeke minheye, düye minheye formasyonu nü derket ne onaje bine sedemi çikirna yekitiye nateva, yekitiye Avrupa, Konsey Avrupa her vaha. Kurna bista yeke min, kurna ke nüye zöy bavariye danım ki şureşe geli kurd, bir Taybet Rojava, Kobani, bir sedemi formasyonu ke nüye, piviste ko iro cihane da بیش نرخ نیو به نیقاش کردن چنین وانا اون نرخ کو مرواتی بیر کردن هتی بن پکیرن نیو دا بین آوا کردن هر وها ام بین شورش آجن خودی درکت نخوازای اکولوژی ماف مروا یم بین گهین وانا همه نیو دا تینه چه کردن جبوی ویجی بر هر تشت شورش روجاوا شورش گلی کرد لکوبانی فرماسیون که نیه جبوی نو نتویه یکی نوامبر قسم جی بتایبتی گله که گلین
پیش اوی که بینه یکی قسم از دخوازم که تا هندک بحثی و بکی که بر راستی جی چونکو دوی کاری دا بجدار بوی لنزیگ را دزانی که دوام ماوی او سه مسال را بودو دا که او جاری سهم ندوی که لیکی مجدار دا که راستی دا او روژه کوبانی به لدار خستن تجربه عالیه پوزیتیو و نگاتیو لوی ماوی دا چی بویا لهر بشی که ولاتین اروپایی؟
بله دست به که گلن اروپی بچک ترس نیزیک دبون برکو ام بیجن سیستما نتو دولتی سیستمی که اوسا شکر بکو ام بیجن شورش نتو عن بطیبت شورش گلی کرد و که تشته که شورشه که تروریزمی آنجی مجادله کسا روات کن بس دما که گلان هدی هدی ناس کرن لینرین که براستی فرماسیونه که نویه یعنی تو تشته خراب جبوی گلاته دا تو نیه جبوی ویجی همی ولاتا دا بطیبت جواکا سیویل بطیبت حرکت اندروی سیستمی بطیبت کارکر گله که پارتین چپ دست بکرم پشگریه جبوی ویجی مثلا روژه کوبانی باشتی بیریم درکتناوی نقاش ای کمین گل هوالا ما لروما کرم لی ایتالیا گل پارتیان کومنیست کارکران جواکا سیویل شورشک دقاومه گلی کرد برخواده ده بس تویکو او تشته ببه نوونه تویه او شورشه پشتوان نقاشانه ما بریار ده که هم یکی مجدار روژه کوبانی اعلام کن همه جهان دا پروپاگاندا و حاضریه و آمادگی بکن که اف روزه همه گل پیروز بکن آن و روزه همه گل بیشتر بکن که شورش گلی کرد ل روزهوا دا پشتگیری بکن کوبانی به پاریزن سر و اساسی مده سپیکر نزدیک 205 باجیرا دا 46 دولت دا روژات امین وک منفستاسیون وک پانل وک سمینار وک شف هات چکرین حیا افغانستان حیا روسیا امریکا ل اروپا همی هر دا جبوی ویجی
بتایبتی ل افغانستان مثلا مظاهره چندین ل چندین جگا مظاهره
سه چار ایالت دا شی بین بتایبتی برکو هر ولاتی ام بیشن نقطه که وان خاله که وید گرد افغانستان به طبیعت جن لی خودی در کتن ولات اندی دیسا جن کارکر
چند تک کشری زور ناسکری افغانی جن هنه که به طبیعتی جی لسر کوبانی پر جاره دنگ دکن مینا جویا مینا خانم که دن هایی که وابزانن به وزوانه در لمانگ دسامبر ده سر بروکسل و آنجی ده فرمو
بله راسته جبوی چه برکو وکی دست پکی جمگو یعنی فرماسیون کنویه یعنی هم بی باری دن قرن بیستی که ده فرماسیون کنوی درد که او جی بطیبت سروک جنا فکر نه لسوریه ده لامبیجن عراقی افغانستان دست پکر شر جهانی سیمین تیجیان کرن وی شر ده جی من خطا شورش کری، من خطا سیمین جناب کرد. زود باشه.
اما بذار گله ولاتانی اروپایی، من بحث کرد که زیر ژاپن و ل آمریکا و آنجی به هر حال به مسئله هم نردی و هم پیوندی پشگیری ها بوی آنها. تا جگه که هون آگاه دار بن میناو کمیته پشگیری اسکوبانی ل آمریکا چهای ل قاره آمریکا ل پیوندی دا چه اکتیویتی چالاکی کی وای؟ یعنی بتا و تیجی او کنون رایتیه. حرکت رجعوا چون امریکا و سر امریکا انده و
بله
لگه هنده کار کرده
به طیبت بانگوازی همه جوی گلانه
بله
یعنی من سیستم آن نتف دولت اف فرم پشگریه که کبکن نینه
بله
Berkuzan ku şuha şerih Rojava da iruke de meşe ve Taybet serkeşi o Türk ke ne kaba statü xazan şorşkerane. Jboy veji bangavazya ma jboy hemi gelane. Amerika ji le ambijen Asya ji Afrika ji le Avrupa ji gel xodi ve şorşe derken. Berku yekem müjdare ambijen persgreka Kurd u şorşa Rojava bi navnetevi. Bel. Berve gringia yek mijdar evaya anagore nerine me anagore khabatin me me baridanin ko isalekej ve hami walata yek mijdar jor be jor şalaki jor be jor şev panel tişte usavçe be
zo başa am bende ki ji bahset tişte aktuel bu kenir rezilmaz euro yani euro jikest euro me programe kayıt deken programe zab deken diara pushra برای یک مجدار دیوشاندن بلا به هر حال ایرو که دبیت 22 مهه لشار بورسا لو اردوغان لعطلش که دا که هبو جگاه که بکردو آنا وابزام جار یکم جنه و بلام گود کو دراستی دا موسل یامنه باجار موسل یامنه و او مسئله جی دراستی دا بتواوی دکویت دجایتی دگل او تصوری که امریکا و ولاتان رجعوایی هیانه سبارت به وضعی که کل عراق داره، چون که هم جرب عصبی دکن که اما دخوازین که یک کتی خاک عراق به پاراستن.
بله.
لپر راجی سروکی دولتی که ولاتی که دن که هشت آجی لکوری لگور قانونی ترکیه آجی به تواوی سروگ نید زانی.
بله.
هشت آجی یعنی قانون نهاتی گوارتن. بلا ما با کیف خودی که آنه دی با عشق را در بجه دلاب موسل بنم. یعنی او لک دانه وقت چه لسه رو گوتنی او؟
نه راستی دیسا پاشتا های گرم برکو دما کم رو دیرو که دنیره لعمر فیودالیزم به طیبت دولت عثمانی دریش کرد به 1453 دما که کت استانبولی عمر فیودالیزم دریش کرد ایرو که دولت ترک این رولی دلیزه یعنی دخواست که که امبیجن عمر دا گر کریه عمر کلونیالیزم دریش بکه سر به اساسی دمیشه. و این نقطه دا از نباورم که بکاره سر بکه و برکو ادی نه گلی رجلات نوین، نه گلی کرد گلی بریه که نه. نجی بین سیستم ایروکی حلال حاضر دولت جهانی دا و دخوازه که او سابقین. راسته برای حتی نه دولت ترک آرمان جوابه حلب بگیره مسلم بگیره بیش رجوا بگشتی بگیره دمام بین مسلم معنای ایالت مسلم ایالت مسلمش باشور کردستانه
راست
دخوازه و هر دمه برکو دماکو دیروکو جمهوریت ترک دنیرن میثاق ملی اوجید که و نبود.
بس
بله بله دماغو برای وقتی ایالات مسلطه نافکرین همه باشور کردستان کرکوکش نافدا هفلرژ نافدا سلیمان فقط یعنی نممکنه برکو یعنی حلال حاضر روشه دا راسته ترکیه هر دم او خیال هنه حتی تنه او ملجنه ملی باتومی وادره دیسا هنه که ملی تراقی او هر دم او خیال هنه او خیال ترانیزم نه برکو نهاد بیژن نه به هر لوزان انرژی برکو هی دماکو بیژن اگر بس چی بی شری جهانی کمین ده پشت دو سه ساعت فرانسیا انگلیزا حرکت نسکنن نه و تارزی مسل اشغال کنه و تارزی حلب گرت نه و تارزی هم روجاوا هم باشور گرت نه امیرو که دخواست کن جرایدی و ولاتانا و اگرم برکو پرانی ترکمنن او جنه راسته راسته ترکمن هنه نکنینن فقط کم نه توک
نه بلام او دو دا رازنا بجه کو یعنی او آلیگری ترکمن هنیه چون هر او روجانه رهبری که ترکمن عراقی اول بیشین میڈیای جواکی را به جوانی دیار بود پر با عشقی را دو که دوانه یعنی او نسمیمیه دو تشتانه دا که دا بیشه بلام یعنی او تشتی که او رو لبورسای او رو یعنی مبستم او رو جکو مبرنامه قید دکن گوتیه دراستی دا هندک تشتی تازه تا ده یعنی او ولات رجعوائی و به طیبتی امریکا کل منطقه دا بیشین نفوزیه لعالی گرا پیویست لهم بری اوانا هندک هلویستیان هبه یعنی بلام او هلوستا تا استاز ضعيف يعني لو سن روجي راب دوداكو او هرش هاتي سركرن بو او بيجن هزا او سوريا بيج شورجرن سوري او تشاناكو دار حال هزا كردي جدات دا باش دار نوانا لو بيوندي دا امريكاي زور ب يعني باحتياط دقدك يعني ايرو روجي بيجن اينه سويج وزاره الدرا امريكا قلت قبل ما اقادر نين لو مساله يعني او مساله كرد او منطقه كرد سوريا هاتنا بمباران كرن ام ليش اقادرين ام عليغري او انك هرتشتي كل غريك ببه بكوردينه ببه يعني تو اقايمه لو انا ببه بكوردينه ما او تشتبو بلام لعين حالي جدا او كبره ايرو يعني هر او روجر دو لاميودا دبجام دخوازم درس تاريخ بمان بدم موصل دا بنمن
بله انا يعني راست تشتهين بهم بس ام باش زانم كو ايروكه امریکا جی گلک حیزن مازن انا گوری برجاندی خود میشن سر و اساسا سیاست دیدکن سر و اساسا دیگه قواتا پشکری دیدکن ان دنگی خواه نادرخن ان چاو خد نخن او راسته فقط ارمان جوا اوه بطیبه چی دمکه کن دا اپراسیون که مازن جبوی رقا جبوی درلزور و دره چیب کن جبوی وی جی دخواست کن بچکه بیژن مساج کی بنه گلی کورجی روجاواجی اگر هن مرا حرکت نکن بنرن الټرناتیو و ترکن هم دین گو گل ترکا هوبن سرویس اساسی می ترکا بدن خپتاندن جبوی و د دنګ خنا درخن یکمینه یا دیمینجه وکینزان هشته مجدار د ساحل بجارتنا امریکایا
بله
سروک دولتین هل بجارتن سرویس اساسی دخواست نکن پروblemی نو گل ترکیه انگل ولات اندین درخن تام بر واجی دخواست کن سرکفت نکیل مسلی دا چه بکن دیاری پارتی دموکراتان هیلاری کلینتون بکن کو نوا جوک آمریکیجی تاثیر کی چه
باشه برز الماز بره کو ام بر دوام ببن از دخوازم اگر از دته به
بله کردم کن
چون کو ما به ترکی شعر خون شعر کیجی به فارسی بخونم کوبانی و دوام بر دوام ببین لگوتن خدا او شعر کسی که بنای شورش نویسندیه در بچه دختران کوبانی بچه کانیت معاشرا دختران خورشید دختران آزادی دختران کوبانی کردستان نگاهش به شماست مگذارید کوههای سربلند این سرزمین رزم سرفکنده شوند به زیر پای شبپرستان پست افکنده شوند دختران کوبانی دختران خورشید شما از ایل و تبار رزمید، خانه هاتان استوار بر پایه های عشق، قدم هاتان محکم، شما راست قامتان سرفرازیست. بچکانید، بچکانید ماشه را که سرود فتح میخواند تفنگ آزادگان، دختران آزادی، دختران کوبانی، بگذارید رها شود بغض های جمع شده در خشاب هایتان و بخندید در این هنگامه نبرد، کین سرود فتح خوشترین ترانه ایست ستم دیدگان را دختران خورشید دختران آزادی دختران کوبانی بچکانید ماشه را
بله ساعت خوش ماست
به دیان شعری آوا به زمان فارسی به زمان ترکی یعنی دو کتب ده هاتیه توب کردن بریا برایز بهرام رحمانی کلو برای حضور کار کرده بریا ویجلو جوینه دا بایه هندکی لقویش قسمان کرده با بلان به هر حال بگرین و سر روژی یکی مجداره به شوی کنکریت او کمیته سالیداریتی لولاتان اروپایی چه دیوه بکه؟
بله نها وکی می گوتیم دخواست کن یعنی همی ولاتا نکو ناوندی جره جره باجاره گنده یعنی او کسی که نکاره تو تشته بکه بکاره مالا خودا الکه تو دمی انا الکه هپگی یپجی درخه و روژه وکه روژه کوبانی اعلام که و پشگیریه کوبانی و روژه و شورشه گلی کرد رواب که
بله گلک سپاس برای زلماز بو بجدارید
گلک سپاس مامست
بینرانی خوشویست بم پیه دگین کتایی ام برنامه تایبتیش من دیاره لو برنامه دا وکو آگادر بون پرانی دوستانو بلین او تکوشرانه که لولاتانی زور بجور اروپایی لکاری هاو پیوندی دا بون دگل کوبانی و دگر روش آوا لو برنامه تایبتی دا توانیان یکتری ببینین جوان لقصکانی یکتری ببین و هر وحا ایوش قصکانی اوان تان دراستی دا تاکو استاد گل من بون جولی بو هیوادارم ایوش به نوره خوتان دراستی دا او هاو پیوندی که گلانی غیر کرد نشانی دادن برانبر به خباتی کردان و خباتی که آزادی خوازانی که لسوریا لسوریا و هر وحا لرجعوای کردستانی دکره لرجعوا دکره در هر حال ایوش بشی خوتانی تخن هیوادارم که او برنامه کلکو سودی خوی هبو به تاکو برنامه که دیکه تایبت لای اوما خوش.